What is animal welfare? How can we define welfare? The established five freedoms describe the states for acceptable welfare. Freedom from hunger and thirst. Freedom from discomfort. Freedom from pain, injury, or disease. Freedom to express normal behavior. And freedom from fear and distress. They are reflected in three components which comprise animal welfare: physical well-being, mental well-being, and the ability to express natural behavior. How we provide physical well-being can seem fairly obvious. It involves animals being fit and healthy, well-nourished, a suitable breed, and given veterinary care when they need it. They need comfortable housing and space to exercise. But what about mental well-being? We know that animals are sentient, which is now even recognized in European law. Sentience means that they are individuals who have feelings that matter to them and can express different emotions. We know they feel negative emotions, such as fear, pain, stress, boredom and frustration, and positive emotions, such as happiness, excitement, optimism, contentment, and even empathy, which means they can share another's emotions. So for mental well-being, we should try to prevent negative experiences and provide lots of opportunities for positive ones. And for natural behavior, we need to provide space, natural, interesting surroundings, and company of their own kind, so they can carry out a wide range of natural behavior. They need the right environment, and we need to provide for them, not deprive them, of what they need and want. For example, broiler chickens enjoy perching, scratching, and running. Dairy cows are sociable animals. They enjoy lying comfortably together, grooming, interacting, and playing together when they are young. Laying hens like to nest and enjoy dust bathing. They even communicate to each other using calls that have different meanings. And pigs are very motivated explorers. They like to root, wallow, and they also like to build nests for their young. Welfare and productivity. Modern food production can come into conflict with animal welfare. This graph shows the relationship between welfare, which benefits animals, and productivity, which benefits people. Without human intervention, animals have a natural state of welfare. If we provide good management from people, such as food protection from predators, veterinary care, and attention to their well-being, then production increases and their welfare can reach a maximum level. However, if animals are driven to produce more, such as through intensive selection for fast growth or yield, their behavior is restricted and they become susceptible to disease. Their welfare can be minimal, which is often the standard accepted for minimum legislation. We need to achieve a balance which maximizes animal welfare in commercial production. Many animals in intensive systems are here, but for good welfare, they should at least be here. So then, how can we achieve good welfare? We need to provide animals physical well-being, mental well-being, and the ability to express natural behavior. All three of these are equally important, and each must be met for animals to have good welfare, positive experiences, and the chance for a high quality of life.